Hallo und willkommen zu Lone Star.
As I was walking down Paradise Street to me, way, blow the man down, a pretty young damsel I chance for to meet. Give me some time to blow the man down. She was rounding the counter and bluffing the bow. Way, blow the man down. She took in all sail and cried, way enough now. Give me some time to blow the man down. So I tailed her my flipper and took her in tow. Way, blow the man down, and yard him to yard him, away did we go. Give me some time to blow the man down, but as we were going, she said unto me, way, blow the man down, there's a spanking full rigger just ready for sea. Give me some time to blow the man down, but as soon as that packet was clear of the bar, way, blow the man down, the mate knocked me down with the end of a spar. Give me some time to blow the man down, it's starboard and larboard, on deck you will sprawl. Way, blow the man down, for kicking Jack Williams commands the black ball. Give me some time to blow the man down, so I give you fair warning before we belay. Way, blow the man down, don't ever take heed of what pretty girls say. Give me some time to blow the man down.
Ja, sehr
What
schön.
Is wrong with me?
Weiß ich auch nicht. Der Erfolg, Häfen bringen mich immer zum Singen, wurde freigeschalten. Vielen Dank für diese kleine Einlage. Ich wollte eigentlich sagen, ja, was hatten wir denn gemacht? Wir haben versucht, dem alten Säufer hier seinen Alkohol abzunehmen.
I don't think I should give him plain milk.
Aber er will nicht einfach Milch.
Milk and cookies sounds great, except not this cookie, no way.
Also, wie kann ich ihm jetzt was anderes geben, außer plain milk? Irgendwie eine aufgeputschte Milch? Irgendwie Milch mit was anderem? Er hat ja gemeint Öl vielleicht noch, aber ich habe das Öl nicht reingekriegt. Kann sie mir helfen? Nee.
She'd probably slap me for even suggesting milk.
Vermutlich.
What? I doubt he'd go for it.
Ich weiß sowieso nicht, warum wir denen irgendwie die Milch andrehen sollten. Kitty legt sich einfach hin.
Old Zadok, huh?
Totally.
What do you mean? It's sad to see him drink himself into an early grave like that.
Yeah, well, my situation's not all gourmet meals and sleeping on fine silks either.
Still wish we could help the guy out in some way.
Preferably in a way that would benefit us, too. Remember? Reversing the spell? Staying on target?
That's what we're here for, aren't we? So, help Zadok and get something out of it, right?
What? I thought you were being rhetorical.
Ja, aber das hilft uns jetzt nicht so wirklich weiter. Dass ich von dem was brauche, ist mir klar. Dass es eine dumme Flasche ist, auch. Können wir mit dem Fisch was machen?
Milk and Fisch.
Das ist so schon eklig genug, da macht das doch auch nichts mehr aus.
Enjoying breadcrumbs is sadly a thing of the past for them.
Also, Kekse mögen sie auch keine. Tja, ja. Dann gehen wir erstmal wieder zurück. Ich hätte gerne das Öl.
Can't think of any use for it.
Doch, ich schon. Er hat gemeint, er kann Öl und Kaffee nicht unterscheiden.
Oh, no.
Wieso denn nicht?
It's not taking me anywhere. No good reason to give it to him.
Das stimmt. Dem Typen allerdings auch nicht.
He can breathe underwater because he has amphibious nostrils.
I'm sorry, who?
Genau. Vielleicht weiß der noch was.
Hey, what did you mean by good luck?
It's no fun if I tell you. You gonna find out yourself soon enough.
Is there something about the Finman house you're not telling me?
You got the wrong person, stranger. Tourist info's over that way.
Not a lot of help from there, I'm afraid.
Help? Oh, you don't need that. Yet.
Manisches Lachen. Tja, wollen wir wirklich in diese dunkle Gasse gehen? Oder erstmal in die Touristeninformation? Vielleicht weiß der ja doch noch was. So einen Kaffeebecher könnten wir brauchen.
About that going away gift.
I take it you've made a wise decision.
I'll have the coffee mug.
An interesting choice, sir. There you are.
Den hat er noch eingesteckt gehabt. Dabei hat er hier oben noch eine ganze Menge.
Any change of heart about me visiting your lovely town?
No. And not a chance of it in the foreseeable future, either.
Thought I'd check. Be seeing ya.
I wish you would reconsider. Good day.
Ich bin mir noch gar nicht sicher, wie mich das jetzt weiterbringt. Weil ich werde den Kaffee nicht bekommen, ich werde das Öl nehmen müssen. Schau mal den erstmal an.
It's my going away gift. Nifty. It's my going away. Nifty.
So, Kaffee.
Got me a cup full of fully fragrant Joe.
Sollen wir doch noch ein bisschen Öl reintun? Ach, wir versuchen es erstmal mit dem echten Kaffee. Ich würde so gern das Öl nehmen. Können wir das vielleicht einfach umfüllen?
Why would I mix these?
Ja. Kann ich den jetzt vielleicht wenigstens leer trinken? Nein, nicht zurück. Vorwärts. So.
Got me a cup full of fully fragrant Joe.
Ja, wunderbar. Schade. Ach, ich hätte dabei echt gern gewusst, ob man ihm auch einfach einen Becher Öl anbieten kann.
Mr. Zadok, I brought you something.
What is it, boy?
Coffee.
What? Get the gosh darned abomination out of my face!
Okay, hat gleich noch eine neue Flasche.
This gives me an idea. So you never tasted or smelled coffee in your life?
Not in my life, son. Couldn't tell it apart from gasoline. It's a question of pensum. Principle.
I gotta run.
Run, boy. Never return.
Ah, wir haben den Becher verloren.
It's old man Zadok's bottle. He tends to throw him when he's angry. Might as well pick it up.
Natürlich. Kitty hatte eh wieder kein Interesse an der Flasche.
It's the empty bottle Zadok threw in anger. What could I be pouring in it? Nah, I don't need any oil.
Nicht? So, jetzt haben wir die Flasche voller Kaffee.
It's a bottle full of strong black coffee. Label saying rare exotic liquor. It's still a bit sticky, could be reused.
Dann kleben wir das doch mal auf die Flasche.
It's a bottle of coffee disguised as rare exotic liquor.
Das sollte ihn doch jetzt überzeugen. Aber ich weiß noch gar nicht, was wir mit der Flasche da machen sollen.
Mr. Zadok brought you something to drink.
What is it?
It's a special kind of liquor. Very exotic import.
Liquor?
Says so on the label. Have a taste.
Why, you dug a little... You almost had me there. You know, it really had a sort of appealing odor to it. But the taste... Never in my wall-seafaring life have I come across something that smelled so enticing and tasted so foul and bitter. Whatever that abomination is, I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy.
All right, Mr. Zadok. I'll try and find you something better tasting.
Go on! Get...
I gotta run.
Kann man jetzt das Öl nehmen?
Run, boy! Never return!
It's old man Zadok's bottle. He tends to throw him when he's angry. Might as well pick it up. Nah, I'll do it.
Aber ob er sich gar nicht fragen wird, warum wir dauernd mit dem Zeug ankommen?
Why would I mix these? It's a bottle of coffee disguised as rare exotic liquor.
Also, naja, dann Milch rein.
It says it's a rare exotic liquor, but it's actually coffee. Now with some added milk, that should make it easier on the taste buds.
Vielleicht noch ein bisschen Öl dazu?
Why would I mix these?
Warum denn nicht? Um es auszuprobieren. Der säuft doch alles, hat er gesagt. Er wird das auch nicht merken.
Mr. Zadok, got you a little something.
What is it?
It's a special kind of liquor. Very exotic import.
Liquor?
Says so on the label. Now, don't expect it to taste like regular hooch. It's very exotic. Supposed to have a real kick to it.
Let me see that.
Okay.
Smells like nothing I ever smelled before. And I can't say it's bad either. What is this devilry, boy? Kinda got me feeling all fluttery inside.
Special import. Supposed to really get you going.
I'll say. Why, I feel refreshed as ever. It's like this curtain slowly lifting off of me eyes and mind, son. Whew, you done old Zadok a mighty good un. Can you get me more of this stuff?
I'll let you know what it is and where to get it. But I'd like that bottle of whiskey in return if that's alright with you.
Ah, take it. Who needs that stuff? I can safely say this has been a full-fledged epiphany, Buzz.
Hey, you remember my name. Thanks.
Not a problem, son. Boy, do I feel good. I just might get up and walk around a little later.
Good to hear, Mr. Zadok. Now that you're refreshed, care to tell me a bit about Fishmouth?
What is it you want to know, Buzz?
So, wir haben die Whiskyflasche bekommen. Jetzt fragen wir dann mal, warum sind es eigentlich hier in Fishmas? Warum sind da alle so verschworen?
Why is everyone so secretive here in Fishmouth?
Where do I begin, my friend? See, you're stuck of a curse that wants to most of Fishmouth's residents' blood, turn them into fish and toad-like things. And then they dig to the water. But that's not even the worst thing.
You'd think that's the worst thing, wouldn't you?
Oh, there's worse. And I've seen it with my own two eyes, hanging around the abandoned factory up Elliot Street. Seen them. Hideous fishmen and octopus-like monsters. Caught a glimpse of them in the moonlight. Heard their awful noises. Horrible. It were horrible.
The curse.
Nah, Buzz. It weren't the curse. These things were not born this way. They was mutants. Abominations. Cobbled together from fish and man and squid. The Butcher. That's who they whisper made those things.
Who's the Butcher?
I don't know that, Buzz. But I suppose it's some shady character that's in cahoots with the esoteric order of Dagon. And they're raising hell in a Fishmouth. Raising hell. Literally.
How can I get to this abandoned factory?
You can't now. They've shut off those streets. In preparation for their evil festival.
Okay. Ich muss übrigens mal sagen, die Sprecher gefallen mir ziemlich gut. Die machen einen tollen Job. Fragen wir mal nach, ob er den Bob Olmsteen kennt.
Ever heard of a man called Bob Olmsteen?
Can't say I ever did.
He's supposed to be staying at the Finman.
The Finman, huh? Folks lodging there have a habit of disappearing without a trace. Sneaky fella, that Finman. Slippery as an eel.
Okay, was hat's denn mit der Esoteric Order auf sich?
What's this Esoteric Order I keep hearing about?
The Esoteric Order of Dagon. Fishmouth folks worshiping the Deep Ones. Dagon's their high priest. Supposed to be this huge amphibian thing. That's what the festival's about. Worshiping Dagon. In sacrifices they bring to him.
Sacrifices? What kind of sacrifices?
I shudder to think, my boy. But what I can tell you is that they're raising something over in Crackham Bay. And if you ask me, it can only be the Half-Goofa.
Half-Go-what?
The Half-Goofa. Huge, ugly sea monster. And yeah, I reckon that sucker's gotta be big, since they ain't letting anyone anywhere near Crackham Bay for a year now. Completely cut it off. No way to enter it from anywhere.
Okay.
I've got a confession to make.
What's that, Buzz?
The whiskey I gave you that you love so much. That's actually coffee.
What? We'll all be darned. You sure pulled a fast one on old Zadok, haven't you? Well, good on you, Buzz. But you know what? Good on me, too. Because I guess you can teach an old dog new tricks. I guess I love coffee, and I gotta live with myself now. I just might be hooked on it.
Well, better than whiskey.
You're right, Buzz. And when you're right, you're right. Right?
Right.
So.
I'll see you later, Mr. Zadok.
God bless you, boy. Take care.
Jetzt haben wir ein paar neue Informationen bekommen. Nice Guy Aura restored. Ein Leben zum Besseren verändert. Ja, sehr schön. Puh. Und nu? Kitty.
Thoughts on Finman?
Wouldn't want him as my neighbor. Or rather, my anything.
Oh, I meant how do we get past him and reach Olmsteen?
He's a more intense guy. I think we need to apply more intense measure.
Murder.
And
Okay, sie hat keine guten Ideen. Aber wieso sollte uns der durchlassen, wenn wir ihm jetzt Whisky geben?
This is the strong whiskey Zadok was pouring down his throat before. I never was a hard liquor, man. I find this stuff awful.
Dann? Weiß Milton noch was?
Catch you later, Milton.
You probably will. My truck's dead.
Hallo.
What's this festival you mentioned?
Nothing you should know of. That's our business. We fish... Fishmouth folk. It's Fishmouth business. We got our own to look up to. Don't need your funny-smelling outsiders telling us what to do and who to listen to.
I might just hang around and check it out if it's happening soon.
That's not to be advised, Skinny. The Order don't take kindly to strangers.
So...
Does anyone take kindly to anyone around here?
Our own outsider. You don't like it, you can skedaddle on out of here.
Where was I?
Dann bieten wir ihn doch mal den Cookie an und was zum Runterspülen.
Mr. Finman, got you a little something to wash down the cookie with.
Let me smell that. Oh, you did good, stranger. You was mighty kind. Mighty kind, I tell you. Ah, that hit the spot.
And here's your cookie.
You ain't tampered with this here fine piece of pastry now, has ya?
Oh, God forbid, no.
Down the hatch! Good. Thanks, stranger. What? What you standing there all expectantly like that for?
Oh, nothing.
What? You expect me to keel over or something? Boy, I got a stomach lined with steel myself. I...
Hätte den Keks nicht essen dürfen?
I don't know what you put in that cookie, but it wasn't working.
I've no idea either, my roommate. Wait a minute! Care to explain what's going on here?
Not until you explain what your business with Mr. Ormstein is.
Okay, I'll come clean. I accidentally got involved in a mess that I can't make heads or tails of. That's why I'm here looking for him.
Vielleicht hätte ich zuerst lügen sollen.
Well, there are two possible situations. Either your heart is full of darkness and deceit, in which case I suggest you turn around and run. Or your intentions are pure and your heart innocent, in which case we can talk.
Soll ich erstmal was Doofes sagen? Aber dann bricht das Spiel vielleicht ab und ich muss neu laden.
My heart is not full of darkness. Boy, it sounds weird saying that out loud. I've been sent here by the voodoo gentleman. I understand Mr. Ormstein might play an important role in this occult situation I stumble into.
Role? No, he plays no role. But what is yours? What part was assigned to you?
Part? I'm just a librarian, sir, and this detective guy came looking for the Necronomicon.
Key type.
Exactly. And then they kidnapped him.
Kidnapped? Who kidnapped him?
Search me. Anyway, I've been walking around with this Necronomicon thing on me.
You have it? The real one?
It's gotta be real. May my cat start talking.
Sup?
Hello. Yes, that explains that.
Well, that's us. What's Ormstein to you?
You speak his name so lightly, let's just say I watch him from a distance. Try and look out for danger, pointless as though that might be.
Pointless? Why?
I just might be a fly buzzing around a lion. Never mind. I don't normally get close to him, but if you do have the real Necronomicon...
Here it is.
An exception will be made. We'll walk up to his room, and we'll see from there.
Ja, auch mal eine coole Stimme. So ein bisschen James Earl Jones-mäßig.
What else was I expecting? He's gone. Again. It might mean they're coming. We must stay vigilant.
They? Who's they?
Oh, too many possibilities in that regard.
Oh my God, all this for nothing. It just keeps getting worse. You might as well at least tell me your name. Mine is Buzz Kerwin, and this is Kitty.
You may call me Barnabas. I am a protector of the other, a seeker of truth and a hunter of evils.
Must look nice on your business card. Okay, first of all, how do you know Dawn?
I was the one who hired him to find the Holy Tome. It should never fall into the hands of madmen.
Soll er so ein bisschen eine Anspielung auf Matrix sein?
Why hire Dawn? Is he an occult detective?
No, but he is a damn good seeker. Well, maybe was.
Oh man, don't say that. I'm sure he'll find a way to pull through. Madmen? What madmen?
The Parish of the Starry Knowledge. The Esoteric Order of Dagon, or the Butcher.
Starry Parish?
Starry Parish? Starry.
Foul worshippers of a thing called the Haunter, and the shining trapezohedron it dwells in.
Trapezohedron? Der sagt das so einfach.
I've heard of the Esoteric Order, what's up with them?
Have you now? So you also know of what they're raising here, in Fishmouth.
The Half-Goofa?
The Half-Goofa? Those idiots. Those complete and utter morons. They have no idea what that can bring about.
Well, neither do I, but are you gonna do something about the Half-Goofa?
They've cut off access to Kraken Bay completely. But I'll think of something. I must.
The Butcher? Tell me about the Butcher.
This is not the place nor the time for that. But what I will say is this. He must not have the Necronomicon. You must keep it away from him, at all cost.
Sounds like someone I'd stay away from regardless.
Do not underestimate his reach, and watch your step here in Fishmouth. Him and the Esoteric Order are likely in cahoots, and they're everywhere.
Okay, so what does he want with the Necronomicon?
To bring this world to its knees.
Okay, that makes sense, sure. Anyway...
Was ist mit Olmstein?
About Olmstein. What did you mean by the other? Olmstein? What makes him other? Who is he anyway?
Though you carry the book, you must understand my reluctance toward telling you these things. Still, see here, though he walks among us, he is not like us.
Oh, geez, with the cryptic talk again.
Dann fragen wir mal, warum er den Finman ausgenockt hat.
If you're protecting Olmstein, how come you didn't knock Finman out earlier?
Nicht
that
früher.
Guy was definitely up to some gruesome stuff. Maybe Olmstein would have still been around.
I was about to take him out. I had reserved all the remaining rooms just to make sure no one would intervene. Then you came along, and I had to be cautious. Maybe I still should be. You do walk around with spiked pastry on your person.
Not spiked enough, but I'm kind of glad to be rid of it. Anyway.
Weißt du denn, wie er der ausschaut?
Can you describe Olmstein for me?
Ha! That would be futile. He might appear different to you than he does to me. Or you might see him clearly and not be able to remember it an hour later. His nature is hard to grasp for all of us.
But the voodoo gentleman described him as just, you know, some friend of his. Was he trying to deceive me, or...?
There's no time to go into this, but that should not surprise you. Olmstein appears in different ways to different people. It is his nature.
Wonderful. Changing subject. So, he does this a lot? Disappear at the worst possible moment?
It is in his ever-changing nature, yes. But there is always, always a little breadcrumb left behind.
Might as well look for it, right?
Yes, I will trust you to do that. I'll keep an eye on the stairs in the meantime. Get to it.
It's what I do. What are your thoughts on all of this, Kitty?
Let's not waste time with chit-chat, man. Squeeze all the info you can out of this Barnabas character.
Right. On it.
Ja, die Informationen haben wir, glaube ich, alle schon bekommen aus dem Barnabas. Und er hat uns den Tipp gegeben, wir sollen nach Brotgruben hier schauen, also beziehungsweise einfach nach einem Hinweis, was denn aus Olmstein geworden ist, wo der sich abgesetzt haben könnte. Aber ich glaube, das machen wir nicht mehr in dieser Folge. Machen wir an dieser Stelle doch ein kleines Päuschen. Und ich hoffe, es hat euch gefallen und wir sehen uns das nächste Mal.